and Christmas sales. We are following those, we are following these peaks here in our P&L. You have different proportions here by quarter. So we are following seasonality. That's why there are quarters which we will have negative results. So that we need to have a cash flow so that we can pay for the negative results.
How are you going to convince investors to invest in something that has negative cash flow? How are you going to convince investors to invest in something that has negative cash flow?
Yeah, they
so what is the next game? If you
interest. Start? They have interest.
Yep. But if
they put money and they receive the money they put plus interest.
Yeah, but if your company is not making money, how can you
make
their money back?
The company is making money. The company is. I just tell you that in some quarters the result is going to be negative, but in other quarters it's going to be positive. In the end, we will have a positive cash flow of $500,000. We pay all the bills, we pay the investors, we give him interest, and we make $500 ourselves.
$500,000.
If you make a second game.
If we make a second game, if we don't make a second game, then the potential is $3,500,000. But as I told you, the idea is that we have a startup. We want to start the company running. We just don't want to make a game and it's done. Okay? Our team is a team of 4 developers, as described in our previous study, which is this is the, our projects. Colder, artist, a musician, because this game has a lot of music load, and a producer. Okay?
So, you know, the first thing is we've given you a template of what we expect in your presentation. Mm. Everything which we asked is not there.
Not?
No, it's not. Elevator pitch, I've not seen it.
Game sorry, sir.
Elevator pitch, I've not seen it.
Game the picture template?
No, it's not. You don't show that today. Sorry, your presentation, you did not show that today.
Yeah,
target audience, you did not show that today. Positioning, you did not show that today. Production plan, you did not show it today. Budget, you did. Risk, you did not. So I don't see a presentation which can convince me.
Oui.
And what you're telling me, so as the investor which you put, you're telling me, if you invest in my first game, you're going to lose money. So I don't want to invest. It's as clear with your presentation. I am convinced I should not invest because you will lose money on your first game and maybe in the future, so it doesn't work.
Yeah, it's just a model. We just
yes. So
I'm
just an investor.
Would show the other stuff.
Agree. I'm just an investor. I don't invest because you're telling me I'm doing a game to lose money. I don't know.
Yeah.
I've got some game who are telling me they are going to make profit. So
I didn't tell you this.
You did?
No, I didn't.
You told me you're positive on your second.
No, it makes $3 million. $3 million. I just told you about the startup idea.
You're telling people you invest in us, we're a startup, we will make 2 good games, and then you will earn a lot of money.
And
you can say that, and then you do not follow a classical structure that we recommend you to use when you want to pitch a game to anybody, not only to us today, to anybody, investors that you might meet in your life. You can do the kind of presentation if you're a genius that has already made AAA games that have been very successful. Then maybe people might say, this guy, I know he's doing good games, that's fine. If you're somebody that hasn't proven anything yet, coming there and telling them, we're going to do 2 games. The first one, I didn't have any information about the USP of your game and what it's. I just saw a little bit of something running, which is good, having a prototype, but I don't remember what you told us last time, so I would need to have a couple of information when you show the prototype. what is the USP, why does it make fun to play this game, why is it really good compared to others, what is special, I don't know, and then you tell me, yeah, I do another game, and then it's going to be all fine. So I cannot be flexible.
I have even put as a note, because it was written, this is not a good business in the long term. It was written.
The startup, yeah.
Yes, but, you know, you're pitching to me to tell me we have a good business, and I see in your presentation something telling me not a good business in the long term.
But then I show you that it's a good
business. 7% interest, no investor is paying for 7% interest. You expect to have 100 or 200%.
Yeah.
That's why they come. Seven, it's better to put the money in the bank, it's risky.
I would never do that. Then we have the free cash flow, which can share with the investor part of the company. That's the idea. That's
the problem is you need to give a very easy feedback so I get a core idea. There are so many things. I'm trying to find what should I write as a summary of what you want to sell me. And the summary I put is it's not a good business in the long term because there is so many things making so different cases, I can't focus my mind. And I think, okay, they are too focused on some things. They don't see the big picture. And as an investor, I want to see a big picture. I want you to tell me, if you invest, we are doing a game which is good, which is going to make money, which is profitable. And in essence, it's not what you're telling us. You need to go way beyond the numbers to find what it is. And so I've got this on the first page.
And maybe one more detail. You have a technical problem, which always happens. You are two of you. One can play, the other one can speak. It's much easier. When you so you were just looking at him fighting with his PC. You can be prepared to say, okay, I will play. Because then you can look at this and you can concentrate on us explaining us the game. So it's a small detail. You do not look like a team. You look like, this is my part, this is my part. But we don't work together.
What I know also is when you have a problem, you always have a problem. So that it's a demo effect. So then you need to demo. It always happens. So. Mm-hmm. So, but when it happens, try to fill the blank. So it doesn't work. It's an opportunity for you to say, the game you've seen, is that what the game is? Is that the feature you want to do? So basically, you don't have people just waiting.
Because what we did, we got our front email, because we have nothing to do, so we just, our mind is, you already lost us. So when we come back, we forgot, or we have another email in our mind. And so not very convincing. And all the, I mean, all the abbreviation and the EVA, FFCS and so on. And you're not speaking to the investors, but it's a lot.
Yes, and so maybe in the context, you're trying to sell a game, not a company. In the exercise we do, it's all about selling and bringing a project on the market. It's not about creating value at the company level to say, I want to share or I want to sell my company. So you need to convince us, not on the company level, but on the game level, that the game has a potential. I know it has a potential because it reaches audience, because we can make it, and because we can market it and bring it to market. And that's what we really want to do. You're trying to convince us that as a company, it makes sense, and it's not what we're asking.
And it's a pity because when I see your other slide, you had a lot of the information we were asking. We just didn't see that.
It was just our presentation strategy that was not what you were expecting.
So, follow the template of the presentation strategy. I think it will help.
Yes. I've seen a lot of pitching in outside, in pitching days, and publisher, when I was a publisher, when I was a developer. It doesn't have to be one-to-one exactly this, but at the beginning it's good to follow the template so that you don't forget, because they will always ask you this. I can guarantee you, if you want to keep on speaking with them, if our investors or publishers, they will want to have a positioning, a business statement, because that's the way they work. They don't want to see about any interest in the future.
you are.
How fast
do you assist me?
You need some?